couple of days ago, myself and Xiao Lei went to Highland Park Service and Sales Center to take a look at the new Autopilot 2.0 cars. Unfortunately, we didn't get to test drive, but I did get to sit in one and take some pictures. So let's start here. We have one of the side markers redesigned. It now has the side rear cameras built in to take rear shots at an angle. This is in the side glass facing forward to take forward wide angle shots. One is on each side, just like the side markers. A little hard to take a picture of those with the reflection. The rear backup camera has been changed. It is a new design backup camera, and it does look a little more clear to me, but it also now features a built-in heater to keep slush and snow melted off and it dry. And the backup camera also doubles as autonomous camera. Now in the front, we have the narrow field of view long range camera, as well as a mid-range wide field of view and a close range extremely wide field of view. Together, these can not only make a stereoscopic image for the autopilot system or autonomous system, but it helps to drive and see at all different angles and distances. So I sat in the car, took a little look at and played around with the screen. From the inside, basically the car acts just like any other current autopilot enabled car. In fact, there's actually less available features on this car than there were on than there are on mine with Autopilot 1.0. So if we go to the driver assistance screen, and I didn't even bother talking while recording this in the car, just because they had background music and there's just too many people. So we'll just do voiceover here. Now, pretty much the only thing is the speed assist, I think I saw. There's actually no autopilot whatsoever. There is traffic aware cruise control is active, but that's it. The actual autopilot started rolling out in the 2.0 cars about a week ago. And it went to 1,000 people, and it's slowly being activated on further vehicles. Functionality-wise, everything else pretty much works exactly the same. There was no premium interior package on this car, so it was missing a lot of other features. It was probably one that someone ordered and just never took delivery, so they used it as the showroom model. Now, a big difference also with the new Autopilot 2.0/autonomous cars is the center screen. Now, I noticed an insane increase in responsiveness of the center screen with the new computer system, which is supposedly about 40 times faster than the Tegra 3-based systems in the Autopilot 1.0 and classic Model S cars. Unfortunately, I was trying to load. I had loaded my Tesla referral page on the browser. I figure why not? I'm sitting there, might as well leave it up. Maybe someone will see it. See $1,000 referral discount. We go, cool. But unfortunately, the browser still isn't compatible. While it is sped up, it's not compatible with a lot of new or a lot of different kinds of web pages. Or just works fairly poorly. It still needs a full browser redesign. But the overall speed, scrolling speed, has increased exponentially compared to first gens. Now, I also noticed this big time on the maps. The load time is still same, about the same as it was on the first gens, maybe slightly faster than the 3Gs. The car was actually on the service center's Wi-Fi, not on the 4G or 3G ATT network. But once it was loaded, the responsiveness of the maps just scrolling around was considerably faster. And even the zooming, all that, it was just much more responsive. opening and closing of the apps. Now, something I did not show when I did when I was playing with the center screen was the quote-unquote smart or stupid zoom, depending on who you are. I prefer to call it stupid zoom, of the nav maps. And the responsiveness of that stupid zoom, smart zoom, giving you your top row of icons back on first-gen cars, there's just too much hesitation. It was much quicker, although I wish Tesla would just get rid of that feature altogether. We have a 17-inch touchscreen display. We don't need it to zoom any bigger for the maps. We can always go full screen. Yeah, there's some insane power usage there, whatever they did to bring it into the showroom through that front door. Otherwise, everything else interior-wise was exactly the same.